Hey, Thrand here, and I'm here with a video where we have several items that have been received from avid viewers and requests for certain types of videos. And I'm very excited to say that we have some really interesting things. We have a package from Andreas Knoll with some beautiful stamps on it. We have a box from Blake Bruning from Trinity Whip Co. Excellent whips in here, I'm pretty sure. And we have a longsword. And this longsword is an Italian-style longsword from Sean Krieger from Krieger Armory. Some of you may know him off of Facebook. And I'm going to open these up right away. And we're also going to do a little bit of possibly experimentation with the items and get a first impression before we come out with actual videos featuring the items. So I hope you all are having a good summer. My summer has been very hectic. I've gone from one job to the next and not had a lot of time for videos. Plus it's been extremely hot, which makes it very difficult to make analog ballistics gel heads like we do over here on our stand and test on them. But I'm hoping to have one out soon, one of the head test videos, and there's a very specific reason you might find out here in the video. I'd like to thank one of our sponsors, VKNG Jewelry, and you can look right here. I'm wearing the Odin ring. It's from the premium line, silver. We did a shield that you see in the background and tested it. A lot of you went and viewed that, the testing, and you watched the construction video because they funded on how to make the Viking Age Lindenwood shield, which we know that goes way back into the migrational age and the legends of Lindenwood. But the shield performed excellently. We showed even how to make the glue, and I did a follow-up video talking about the glue and some recent testing done by the Society of Combat Archaeology and Rolf Warming. They made a shield recently with some research that they found, the Birka shield, grave 850, and it had tanned hides on it. So they made a tanned hide shield, pretty much like the Trilleborg shield, the size of it, and it performed excellently, much like we had with this shield here and my Goxyship shield. So be sure and check that video out. In that video, I also address Arne Coetz and his ideas on the Goxyship shields, which he did a very elegant, well-spoken video with his views, and I give him a rebuttal, so to speak, or what I believe about it. We agree on a lot of things as well. So be sure and check that out. But what I wanted to say is VKNG Jewelry reactivated the codes. The only one that's still active now, and it'll be for another 7 days or so, 7 to 8 days from when this video comes out, 20% off. So the 20 Thrand code, I'll include that at the bottom. So you can click on that and go straight to VKNG Jewelry, and they're having a summer sale. So everything's anywhere from 15 to 50% off, and it stacks with the 20% off. So I'd like to thank them once again for sponsoring videos like this and historical videos at that. Wait, I almost forgot. I got carried away after doing the first half of the video and I started testing this wonderful Italian longsword by Sean Krieger from Krieger Arms with the round, a technique from Ledall's Roll. It's an English longsword text and from around the 16th century. Chris Sizemore, I used his technique that he decided was probably what he was talking about, and I'm thinking he might be completely right. So stay tuned to see this testing here. But I wanted to stop real quick in the middle of the video and let everyone know I have a very important project. I will be going back up to Asfolk. It's been almost 2 years since the last time I was there, and I came back with awesome, spectacular videos handling historical weapons, testing European techniques from the actual manuals and from actual recreation of Viking Age sword and shield techniques. Yes, it was excellent, all the videos we had. We had a seminar by Craig Johnson from Arms and Armor and the Ewart Oakeshott Institute, and there may be possibilities to go back to the Ewart Oakeshott Institute and Arms and Armor, plus hang out at Asfolk. Folk, hang out with Roland Vorzecka and get more valued information from him, and Arthur von Eschen, the living historian and Viking Age combat expert himself. The only thing is, they're not able to pay for my ticket this year, so I've set up a Fundly account. I would like to thank everybody. I'm already up to $155. I only need about $600 to be sure I can make it up there. As it gets closer to time, of course, the ticket gets more expensive. The quicker we get it, the more excess money I'll have left over if we can get to $600, so I can buy SIM cards and extra batteries so I don't miss any footage and cover any excessive costs for carrying extra camera equipment, because I want to make sure I get the entire thing this time. I missed out a lot last time. I came back with a lot of awesome videos. Most of y'all know this from Asfolk Viking Martial Arts and the Ewart Oakeshott Institute. But this year, we're going to have Roland Vorzecka teaching a seminar, and we're going to have me hosting a Forged in Fire style weapon making competition and testing competition. So yes, it'll be very much like Forged in Fire, but our differences, it'll be Thrand style, and we're going to be forging everything historically accurate. So if you're interested in it, be sure and contact Asfolk Viking Martial Arts. They'll give you all the parameters on it. I know it's got to be a charcoal fire with period tools. If you think you can do that, be sure and contact them. If you can send the weapon up there before the actual event, which will happen in about 2 months, we will be testing your weapon. If it wins, it'll be featured on the Thing Thrand YouTube channel in the testing and the competition and the judging, and then featured as a unique weapon forged historically and shown for all its greatness. So I hope you enjoy the idea of this as much as I do. And if you can go by Funley, and it's Funley, send Thrand to Asfolk Viking Martial Arts, or Funley take Thrand to Viking Martial Arts. Yes, I think it's actually under that in the URL. You can also find links to it on Facebook. But anyway, thank you so much for helping me so far. If you can't actually help out with donations, just share it to lots of people. Hopefully they'll want to see these videos, these historical videos, come to par, and the awesome competition. And back to the video. But without further ado, let's get straight into box opening. Our first package comes from Andreas Knoll. And the first thing Caddy got excited about, and I did as well, it has Asterix and Obelix comic book stamps with the actual backing, the background on it, and the stamps. So it's beautiful. This is a great collectible box now, the way he set it up. And he's got some other beautiful stamps from Germany. If you look at them, it's hard to see them very close. I'll try to get a close-up picture of the box to show this off to everybody. And just the packages alone is spectacular. But what's in here is to bring up that shield video. If you look at the shield behind me, I had to get some nails that were similar to medieval nails and anneal them. The reason why is I used masonry nails that are square. I had to reshape them after annealing them. This means heating them up to red hot and letting them cool on their own, just to have proper nails to clinch, to do clinch nails on it, to put it together. I was supposed to be getting proper forge nails like I used on my Goxted ship shield replica from Andreas Knoll, but he was having trouble getting it to me because of, I guess, the postie in Germany shipping it. Somehow they lost the first package. So he was kind enough to send this one to us. And let me go ahead and get this going here. He should have some really good goodies in there. And by the way, we will have more stuff coming out by Medieval Shop. This was a utility blade they sent me, which is a folding knife. And yes, we've covered that already in a previous video. They are ancient. They had them way back in time. Let's go ahead and see what we got here. First thing I noticed on top, and he had promised me some, we have archery gloves. Nice, very nice. Three-fingered. Looks like it should fit me well. And a lot of people would say these aren't period, but we do have late century depictions of longbowmen with gloves very much such as these. I mean, I'll show a depiction of it. I don't know how common these were. I know that they wore full gloves a lot of times just on the hand that they drew the longbow with. But this is much more nimble. I very much appreciate it, Andreas Knoll. And he even included the bow hand. Might need a slightly bigger one, I don't know. But this is to actually help support the bow in the hand and help with the grip and the draw. So yeah, these are gonna help me out immensely. I think I shall enjoy it very much. Thank you, Andreas Knoll. I can certainly use these in upcoming videos, and I think they'll aid me in further testing with the longbows, especially when I get into the 130-pound bow that you see behind me over there. He sent an extra one of the other hand as well. That's an extra large. This will probably fit better than that one. Thank you very much. I think you're right on that. That's probably the best way to go with a slightly bigger one. Let's see what else we have. We have Shaka Cola. This was a chocolate that we got in a previous video. We got one can of, or two cans, I believe.
Two cans and the kids ate half.
And we did a German candy tasting video. It's here on Thane Thrand YouTube channel. My boys, the Viking kids, are in it. It also showed up on their channel. Their channel's sort of been dead. They haven't really been wanting to put much in it. I don't force them. I'll let them do what they want to do. They've been talking about starting it back up, so we might start putting some videos out there and maybe a few of their videos on this channel if y'all like the idea. Let me know. Give me a comment down below about that. But the Shaka Cola, it has the cocoa bean in it for the chocolate. It has cola bean in it for caffeine, and actual coffee. The coffee gives it a strong caffeine effect. So yeah, it keeps you awake. It was one of the first energy chocolates, as you see those nowadays. They're actually putting those out there, chocolate with caffeine in it. They came about 1935, if I'm not mistaken, because I did some research on it. In 1936, it was promoted as a energy chocolate for the Olympics, believe it or not. And during World War II, German soldiers were issued this, especially pilots and bombers, to help stay awake. It was in their rations, their provisions. So a lot of the German soldiers used this stuff to stay awake for being sentries, staying awake at night. And it was a very popular thing during the war. But just most of all, it's just really good chocolate. Don't have to eat a lot, and it gives you a nice little wake-up buzz if you want to wake up in the morning. We love this stuff. He looks like he's got several cans in here. Wow, four cans. That is going to keep us up well. Thank you, Andreas. And I'll talk. Oh, and here is the nails, the infamous nails that we didn't get. I have the forged nails right here, and he sent me plenty. So we do further videos and further video tests working with Viking Age shields. These are soft steel or iron. They're actually forged nails. And yeah, they work the best of anything I have used yet. And I think they're the most historically accurate I can get, at least forging them myself. So thank you once again, Andreas Noel. Hope everybody enjoyed this little package. I know I do, because I can't wait to have more of the chocolate. Let's go ahead and see if I can get this back in here quickly. And I will just set it back here for now. Our next package. I can already tell this is going to be nice. We have whips from Blake Bruning. He's been making whips for over 13 years. And he wanted to make me a target whip, one of them. This is a 6 foot long whip. You can coil it nicely for it's new. It's a burgundy, and it's very much something like Zorro would use. Like you would picture a shorter whip to work quickly with in a fight, like in a fight scene like that in a movie. Very nice, nice long fall. It's got a cracker on the end, and he supposedly sent me a large amount of poppers or crackers for the end, and extra falls, and whipped cream. So I should have everything I need to keep these whips up and do some nice whip work in a video. As most of you know, I had a whip a while back that I had made, very much like a David Morgan style whip. And that's the kind of whips that Blake Bruning makes. He makes only the finest. They use them at Disneyland in the Indiana Jones stunt show, where they do the whip work and everything in it. So he provides all those for them. He's done over 1,000 whips, and they're used in movies. There's an upcoming TV series his whips will be used in, and I'll give you a hint on that later. Beautiful. This is like the Cairo Flare. This is an 8 foot Indiana Jones whip, bullwhip, done in David Morgan style, covered in actual kangaroo hide or kangaroo leather. Beautiful. I love the smell, and I cannot wait to get to work with these. Let's see what else we have in the box quickly before we continue. Just like he said, lots of poppers or crackers, ton of falls if I need them, whipped cream, and some of his cards here, which I'll show a close-up of one of the cards. He makes some spectacular stylized whips for performers. So I mean, he'll make you anything from a whip that looks like a lightsaber to stylizing it with your personal logo or emblem on it. I mean, actual plating where it's different colors. He can do just about anything, and it's all by hand. This man is one of the fastest whip makers, because the way he trained is he doesn't take measurements. He just cuts laces, and he's very, very quick from what I understand. Beautiful whips. Thank you again, Blake Bruning. I plan on getting out quickly with these whips and actually showing something spectacular, hopefully. But I am going to be doing some practicing with them to make sure that I can use them properly.
Somewhat so we can compare speeds on them.
Yeah, and one of the ideas I have for a video, he likes the idea of self-defense because he practices both Jeet Kune Do, Kali, or Arnes, or Eskrima, and very realistic Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So what I would say about this is the man likes the idea of self-defense, so I'm thinking about using the whips and testing them on everything from an analog ballistics gel head to stuff that we might be able to actually damage to see how much effect it would have if you actually had to use it for self-defense and landed a good hit on somebody or something. We'll see how that works out. The wind knocked our box over, and I'm not going to lie to you, I'd already cut this, but I haven't totally unwrapped the longsword. This one is from Sean Krieger. And Sean Krieger has Krieger Armory on Facebook. You can check him out and look him up. And we have a longsword that's an Italian style. Because Chris Sizemore is a HEMA instructor starting his own school. He's been working at HEMA for a while. And his interpretation of Ledall's Roll, which is actually an English fencing text from later century, around 16th century, shows a technique called the round. And it basically describes using the sword in such a way that you attack, which I'll be opening this up, and come back around. Now, his interpretation is different than some people's. They think it means something like this, and then coming back around with a Threchow. But we'll go ahead and explore this later. Right now, I want to open this up and see what kind of blade we got. I've already seen some of his blades online, and they're spectacular. Please forgive the box falling over. The wind is horrid today, even with a longsword in a box.
But it makes up for the heat from the sun normally.
Oh, yeah. It is so hot right now. Let's see if I can get this out. It's got a nice metal tip on the end to make sure. Ooh, yeah. Now, this is a beautiful longsword. I think this is going to be some fun. Very much think this is going to cut very well. We've got a razor sharp edge. Something I'm not used to. I'm used to receiving blades a lot of times that they say are razor sharp and I have to sharpen them myself. This is beautiful. Get the hairs off the blade here. But I very much am looking forward to that technique. I plan on trying to get that out as one of my next videos. Bed. And actually test this beautiful Italian design longsword out. A lot of times he does fetters and swords that are used for HEMA and blunts. This one, I think he's outdone himself. It is razor sharp and very beautiful. I can already see this is going to be a fun sword. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed our video today. I didn't want to go on too long. I just wanted to get these out of the box, show my little experiments with them because I'm sure you've seen those. Just figure I put them in while I'm talking so it doesn't take too long and take too much of your time because I'd like to come back with some really action-oriented videos. And like I said, just so I don't forget, I have plenty of stuff from an Medieval Shop. We still have a buckler, all steel buckler. I also have some other stuff from them, a sax. And we also have these fine items here and many other things in store that I plan on getting out as soon as I can. I planned on doing them this summer, but I had some problems where I was trying to switch around from one job to the next and ended up in a better position, but it kind of took the roundabout and didn't have a lot of time to make videos like I planned. Anyway, as always, I hope you've enjoyed the video and you'll tune in for the rest of the videos. And farvel.
If you'd like to help support the channel, you can always sport a Thane Thrand YouTube channel shirt that you can get over at viralstyle.com at the Thane Thrand merchandise store. We have coffee mugs, koozies, a wide variety of shirts and hats. You can also help support us on Patreon, and if you do that, you'll also get exclusive content that can only be seen there.